Hey guys, recently OpenAI released a new feature called ChatGPT Code Interpreter. In this video, I will show you what it does, and by the end, I will tell you what I think about it. So without further ado, let us dive in. To use the new feature, you need to have a ChatGPT Plus subscription. And to activate it, go to your settings and look for beta features. In there, you will find the option to turn on the code interpreter. After you do that, you will see a new choice under the GPT-4 model. Alright, to test it out, I want to analyze the following Excel file. Here we have data on supermarket sales across different branches. And instead of digging into this data myself, I'm going to let ChatGPT do the job. To do so, I just need to upload the file. When I click on this icon right here, I can pick my spreadsheet and give it a prompt. We will start simple. I will ask what this dataset is all about. And just like that, ChatGPT analyzes this dataset by running Python in a safe sandbox environment. As a result, it summarizes the data and explains what each column means. To get to this information, ChatGPT ran some Python code, which you can see right here. You can also see the result in the container below. As we can see here, the Excel data didn't start from the first row. That is why we see some none values. But ChatGPT caught this and adjusted the code accordingly. It tried again, this time skipping two rows. But the result still had an empty header row, so it tried again. On this attempt, ChatGPT ignored the first three rows and then figured out what the dataset was about. With a basic understanding of the data now in place, let's check how clean or messy this dataset is. In real-world examples, it's a good idea to clean up the data before doing any sort of analysis. But in our case, the data seems pretty clean. There's one empty column, but apart from that, there are no duplicates and the data type seemed to be identified correctly. So I asked, what are the top 5 insights from this data? And this is where things get interesting. Without much direction, ChatGPT ran some Python code and offered the following insights. First, branch number C had the most sales. Next, it found out which product line sold the most. It also noticed that most customers like to pay in cash. And lastly, it found that branch C had the highest average customer rating. To be honest, these are pretty basic calculations, as you can see in the code. But still, I think it's a decent starting point. And if you're interested in the actual numbers, you can check out the result in the sandbox over here. But I think it would be more interesting to plot those numbers. So I asked ChatGPT to take these insights and turn them into some plots for us. And just like that, it generated the graphs and gave a quick rundown of what each one is showing. And as before, if you are curious about the code it used, you can find it here. ChatGPT used Matplotlib and Seaborn to craft these charts. One little issue though, the charts are pretty small. I tried downloading it by right-clicking and saving it as an image, but it didn't have a file extension. After saving it and trying to open the file, I had no luck. I actually had to rename the file and adding .jpg at the end, and then I could open it. I think those charts don't look very professional, but I didn't ask for anything fancy. So I decided to ask more precisely. I wrote, "Can you create more professional looking Python charts suitable for a presentation? Also, each analysis should be represented in an individual image. The images should be in PNG format." This time I got a separate chart for each analysis. And it even created direct download links. When I click on it, we can see that ChatGPT also provided a suitable file name. The look of the chart itself hasn't actually changed, so I might need to be more precise in my prompt. But for now, I'm good with this. Okay, now let's say you are happy with your data analysis. The next step would be to come up with some solid recommendations for your management. So I asked ChatGPT, based on your analysis, what potential actions would you recommend we take? And I have to be honest here, I find the answers quite fascinating. Keep in mind, I didn't provide ChatGPT with a lot of context. I just uploaded a dataset and asked it to analyze it. So, of course, we need to take its recommendations with a grain of salt. However, it recommended expanding in some specific product lines since they generated the highest total sales. It also noticed that branch C had the most turnover, so the recommendation is to investigate why the branch is more successful than the others. Could it be the location, the stuff, product variety, or something else? Also, as most customers pay by cash and e-wallet, promotion on these payment methods might boost sales. And speaking of Branch C again, it had the highest customer rating, so it might be worth taking a closer look here again. Okay, to wrap this up, I asked ChatGPT to prepare a PDF report to summarize your findings, including visualizations, main insights, and recommendations. Unfortunately, ChatGPT couldn't generate a clean PDF report. It just displayed the charts again and said it couldn't include the text in the PDF. So when I downloaded the PDF report, it was just the same old charts we had seen before. That is why I asked ChatGPT to write the report in the chat. And just like that, we get our key findings and recommendations. Honestly, I don't know about you, but I find this tool fascinating, especially considering it's still in beta phase. That means it's only going to be better from here. Plus, it can analyze text document and manipulate images too. If you would like, I could also make another video showcasing more examples. But in this video, I just wanted to give you a quick peek at what this new feature can do. Now, it's not without limitations. Currently, you can only upload files like CSV or Excel files for data analysis. You cannot directly connect it to your database yet. But remember, this feature is still in beta. I'm sure they will add some kind of data connector in the future. Also, keep in mind that Python needs memory to analyze your data. If you got a massive dataset and you are running heavy computations on it, the sandbox 2GB of RAM might be not enough. But I'm optimistic that these are temporary limitations. My main concern is that I cannot run it locally. So I personally wouldn't upload any sensitive company data. But regardless, I think it's worth exploring to see the direction where we are heading and what's already possible with AI. If you want to try it out yourself, I've put together some sample prompts and uploaded them to my GitHub page. Feel free to copy and paste them from there. And finally, I would love to hear your thoughts on this code interpreter. Share your views in the comments. And as always, thanks for watching and I will see you in the next video.